صلوات پر محمد والے محمد. مقتل میں گر رہا ہے, مقتل میں گر رہا ہے, سنبھالو حسین کو یا فاطمہ, ردا میں چھپا حسین کو. پیوست ہے غریب کے پہلو میں برچیاں, تم کو بھی اٹھنے دیتی نہیں ٹوٹی پسلیاں, اور لے کر علی کا یا فاطمہ ردا میں چھپا لو حسین کو. دیوار و در کے بیچ جو ارمان رہ گئے, رکھی ہوئی تھی دل میں جو محسن کے واسطے, وہ لوریاں بھی آج, وہ لوریاں بھی آج سنا لو حسین کو. یا فاطمہ ردا لو حسین کو. اور سولہ پہر کی پیاس ہے اور ہے لبوں پہ دم, دے کر غریب بیٹے کو عباس کی قسم. اور پانی اگر ملے تو, پانی اگر ملے تو پلا لو حسین کو. یا فاطمہ ردا میں چھپا لو حسین کو. شہ کی غریب بیٹی کے ارمان کی طرح گودی میں لے کے تیسری شابان کی طرح, کچھ دیر ہو سکے تو, کچھ دیر ہو سکے یا فاطمہ ردا میں چھپا لو حسین کو. یا فاطمہ ردا میں چھپا لو حسین کو.
ماشاء اللہ, ویری ویل ریسائٹڈ کریم, گڈ جاب. I would request Sheikh Jaleel to please come and start the majlis. Let's have loud salawat for Sheikh. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. Everybody please come as close to member as you can.
Oh. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، سيدي وحبيبي ونور قلبي أبي القاسم محمد. وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين الذين أذاب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا. سورة المباركة الفاتحة في المرحوم محمد عبد الله ابن محمد إسحاق. May Allah be pleased with his soul. سورة المباركة الفاتحة. صلوا على محمد وآل محمد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قال الله العلي العظيم في كتابه الكريم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون. صدق الله العلي العظيم. This evening, I would like to discuss one of the hot topics of the time in our Shia world, which often comes here and there. And the topic is nothing but about taqleed. Today we have many Muslims, and especially from the Shia school of thought, who question the legitimacy of taqleed. They say, why should we do taqleed? What is the proof that we have to follow someone? That's question number one. Question number two. Assume we have to follow someone. We accept we have to follow someone. But why somebody in Iraq or Iran? Who doesn't even know what America is all about? Never been America. Never been to Washington. Doesn't know the lifestyle of Washington. And I should listen to him to tell me what to do in the United States. How can that make sense? That is the second question. Question number three. Now, assume I want to follow him. I have to follow him. What is the proof from the Quran? O Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam. And we make this topic very important. You hear some scholars, I don't want to mention names, out of the respect for this member. Some scholars, they also say, no, you don't have to be taqlid. Taqlid was invented by one or two people just to control your home's money. As if the Maharaja never ate, never had a place to sleep until you give them your homes. So they said, this was all invented. It has no base, not from the Quran, nor from the hadith of Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam. And tonight, or this evening, I just want to give you, brothers and sisters, just open your mind and your heart. One or two ayahs from the Quran, one hadith from the Ahlul Bayt, or even more than that, that's two, and three, just the logic. Because you know, our Islam is about logic. Because one of the usul al-istinbat, our maraja, when they make a ruling, one of the resources that they used to give you Islamic verdict is aql too. Aql is involved. And we have a saying in Usul al-Fiqh, مَا حَكَمَ بِهِ الْعَقْلُ السَّلِيمُ حَكَمَ بِهِ الشَّرْعُ. When a sounded mind, sounded aql, came to a conclusion that is good, you will say Islam says good too. Because Islam is about aql salim, sounded mind. So for that matter, where do we start? As a proof from the Quran that taqleed is something that is not rooted in the Quran. Now before we go there, what is the meaning of taqleed? First of all, a taqleed in Arabic, literally, it means to follow. Qallada, meaning you follow someone. So in Arabic, a taqleed is to follow. Or it comes to mean to imitate someone. That's called taqleed. That's literally in Arabic. Now, in Shia school of thought, when they say a taqleed, what do they mean? Is a person who has not reached to the level of ijtihad to follow someone who has reached to the level of ijtihad. In other words, taqleed is to follow al-mujtahid al-jami' al-shara'it. You know, to follow a grand scholar who meets the conditions. If a person, an alim, proven, and inshallah I'm going to tell you, how can you prove that this is a marja and jami' al-shara'it? I'll tell you in a minute. But the first thing is, if it's proven, this person is marja or mujtahid, jami' al-shara'it, following him becomes what we call taqleed. So the taqleed, to follow a grand scholar who meet the condition of ijtihad or al-marja'iyya. Now, what is the proof that we have from the Quran, which Allah tells you it is okay to follow somebody who knows or somebody who is knowledgeable? The ayah we read is one of them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah said it is your obligation, responsibility to ask he who know when you don't know. Now, do you need any answer better than this? Allah is telling you in the Quran, fas'alu, and fas'al in Arabic, sigatul al-amr, wal-amru yufidul wujub. Ulama usul al-fiqh, they said there is a way to search a command, and when the word came in that form of command, it means wajib. For example, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Aqimu salah, how do we know salat is wajib? Because the format of the word Aqimu, sigat al-amr, wal-amr yufidul wujub. Allah says, Fas'alu, must ask, ahl al-dhikr, people who know more than you. What should I ask him? In kuntum la ta'lam. When you don't know. Now somebody can say, okay, but this is a general topic. Right? Now let me give you a specific one, which has to do with the religion from the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَوْلَا نَفَرٌ مِّن كُلِّ فِرْقَةٍ مِّنْهُمْ طَائِفَةٌ لِيَتَفَقَّهُوا فِي الدِّينِ وَلِيُنذِرُوا قَوْمَهُمْ إِذَا رَجَعُوا إِلَيْهِمْ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَحْضَرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, let it be. Now this is specific in fiqh. Because with the first one, you can tell me it's a general one. Now I'm giving you a specific in fiqh where Allah says, فَلَوْلَا نَفَرٌ مِّن كُلِّ فِرْقَةٍ. Let it be in every group. Which group? Every group. Everyone. مِّن كُلِّ. In Arabic, كُلْ يُفِيدُ الْأُمُومِ. Every. There's no specific. Everyone. مِّن كُلِّ فِرْقَةٍ مِّنْهُمْ طَائِفًا. Let it be among every group. Take some group out of them, liyatafaqqahu, to learn fiqh, to know the rules of Allah. Now Allah is telling you, especially in fiqh, liyatafaqqahu fi din, let them learn about the fiqh in the religion, right? Then what did they do? Allah said, then when they come back to their people, right, the people have to listen and follow them because of what they are hearing. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَحْضَرُ. Now this ayah is specific to the point of taqleed. That is, ayah talking about taqleed. Now, if this is clear, that is number one. Number two, now somebody can ask, okay, now, what do we have a proof from the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam about specific taqleed? There are two hadith from Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. Number one, which is quoted from Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam. Salla ala. Which he too, after he made that, our 11th Imam, Imam al-Hasan al-Askari alayhi salam. Allahumma salla ala. He said quoted. Quoted from whom? The sixth Imam. Is hadith. What did he say? He said, during the ghaiba of my son. Which is his son? Imam al-Hujjah. During his ghaiba, if you could not reach him to get the verdict of Allah, قال الله قال الرسول, from him, what should we do? He says, من كان من الفقهاء. This is from Imam Hassan al-Askari, which he is quoting from whom? Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq. He said, whoever among you at that time reached to the level of ijtihad, which has become faqih, where he's knowledgeable when it comes to fiqh. Man kana min al-fuqaha. That's the rule number one. He must be faqih, knowledgeable, aspect in fiqh. That's one. Number two, also sa'inan li nafsi. That's condition number two. He, the faqih, sa'in, protect himself. That's number two. Protect him from what? He protect himself by making sure that he is doing the right thing. Which means, if you have a faqih, but he's not doing the right thing, can we follow him? No, we cannot. He has to be sa'inan li nafsi. He protect himself to make sure that he's doing the right thing. That's number two. Number three, hafidhan li dinih. He protect his religion. What does he mean? If today an atheist comes and says, there is no God, I can prove there is no God, then what is the role of a marja or mujtahid? He has to stand and give his knowledge to prove otherwise. That is one of the responsibilities of mujtahid al-jami' al-shara'i. That's number three. Number four, I said, mukhalifan hawa. He has to go against his evil desires. Give you an example. There's a youth here, mashallah. That's why I'm going to give this example so that we understand that if you ever have a marja or mujtahid, right, but he's not observing the rules of Allah. Tomorrow you see the mujtahid, mashallah, in the nightclub, drinking, and partying. No, we can't follow that marja. He has to be mujtahid for his. مُخَالِفًا لِهَوَى. He goes against his own evil. Why? Because he's a leader to these people, so he has to live by example. That's why مُخَالِفًا لِدِينِ لِهَوَى. Then what happened? It says نار أولي ذا مُطِيعًا لِأَمْرِ مَوْلَى. And he also submit to the order of his master. Who's his master? الإمام الله صاحب العصر والزمان. صلى الله عليه وسلم. If he has all of these conditions, what did Imam say? He said, فَلِلْعَوَامِ أَن يُقَلِّدُوا. In that sense, then people who are not marja or mujtahid, they should follow him. This is Imam al-Hasan al-Askari, huh? Good. Now somebody can say, okay, what about Imam al-Hujjah himself? What did he say? I'm going to give you another hadith from him too. Now, where did this hadith came from? Al-Imam al-Hujjah said this to his last na'ib. And it's amazing, amazing. To Shia, I'm talking. Because Shia, you said, Rasulullah, it's not possible for him to die. Right? Without appointing successors. We all agree on that. Don't we say that? Good. Does it make sense? Rasulullah died without a successor. So we prove that Rasulullah, before he left this dunya, he appointed whom? Imam Ali. Good, that's what Shia you say. Good. And you also believe Imam al-Hujjah in Ghaibatul Sughra. Ghaibatul Sughra, he knows he's coming back, right? He appointed four. One of them died, the second one came. He appointed the third, he died. The fourth one came. Now in Ghaibatul Kubra, which is not coming, no, he left without telling you to do anything. And that's in your mind, right? Say Imam al-Hujjah, for Ghaibatul Sughra, he appointed four. Al Kubra, the longer one, no, he said, no, I'm tired of you guys. You do whatever you want to do. And you accept this logic? A'udhu billah. Now Imam al-Hujjah, before the fourth occultate, before the Ghaibatul Sughra, he told the fourth Khalifa, he told them, he says, "Unzuru ila huffad riwayatina." He told him, my Ghaibatul Kubra, look, those who know our hadith and understand the hadith properly. Okay, I found them. Then what? Imam al-Hujjah say it. He said, "Fa'innahum." If you find those people, "Hujjati alaykum." Those individuals, they are my hujjah upon you. Kama anni hujjatullahi alayhi. The way that I am hujjah of Allah upon you, they become hujjah upon you too. Imam al-Hujjah is saying, huh? Good. Now, who is the marja al-jami al-sharaq that we have to follow? There are many ways to find out. Number one, a scholar who have learned and proved from his knowledge that he is faqih. Through teaching, through research, prove that he is faqih. That's number one. Number two, aw shahidain adilain min ahli al-ilm. Two adil scholars who are experts in fiqh. They first, this is a mujtahid jami' al-sharaq. That's number two. Number three, they said, ashya'u al-mufidu lil-ilm. Which means, when news get around that this person is mujtahid and jami' al-sharaq. To the point, you cannot even doubt about it. Example, like Sayyid Sistani today. Do anybody doubt that he's a marja, jami' al-sharaq? No. That becomes a proof that he is a mujtahid and jami' al-sharaq. That is from the hadith. Now let's come to the logic. It's amazing that we, all of us, we do taqleed every day in other part of life, but when it comes to Islam, we question. Every one of us is mukallid in every matter of life, except in Islam. How? Today you and I, you want to buy a house, right? And you are not a real estate. What do? You look to a real estate, who you trust, and you seek his opinion. Don't we do that? And then with his advice, what do? You buy the house. Now, what do you call that? Taqleed. Because you listen to him and his advice, and you go according to what he says. Don't you? That's taqleed. Not only that, in a matter of health, we all have doctors. Don't we? La samahallah. At some point, you need a surgery. The doctor tells you need a surgery. Sometimes you say, no, let me get another second opinion. What do you call that? That's taqleed, right? Now, you go to another doctor, you hear his advice. What do you think? Then the doctor says, yeah, I think it's a good idea to do ABC. Then finally, based on that doctor's recommendation, you go through surgery. What do you call that? That is called taqleed. But when it comes to Islam and Sharia, we question, why should I do taqleed? Why should I follow a marja? Now, let me tell you one important reason you have to follow marja, brothers and sisters. We all know as Muslims, there is a court of Allah we all have to stand. Don't we do it? Every Muslim knows, Yawm al-Qiyamah, there is a court of Allah. We will stand and we have to answer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Good. Now, in that court, there are people called lawyers. You know you are not an expert in laws. You go into a court system, the judge is sitting, right? If you want to win a case, what do? You look for a good lawyer to represent you in that court so that you don't have to talk, you don't have to say anything. Because that lawyer does all the work, doesn't it? Yes, that's what we do today. Now, in the court of Allah, if you don't want to get in front of Allah to answer your questions, the lawyer who can speak on your behalf is marja al-jami' al-sharaq. That is why, if you look in Risala al-Amaliya, the Maraji' they wrote, they write in the beginning of the first page, they said, "Al-amalu ala tibqi hadhihi al-fatawa mujzin wa mubri'u al-dhimma." They said, acting according to these opinions of that marja, I said, it's sufficient between you and Allah. Not only that, I said, also Yawm al-Qiyamah, I will answer Allah on your behalf. Now, do you want to stand in front of Allah? In the court of Allah, Allah tells you, how did you do your wudu? Say, Ya Allah, I thought Ayatollah Google told me, and based on Ayatollah Google, I did this. So, Ya Allah, you think Ayatollah Google is going to start, what they call, defend you in front of Allah? Oh no, a marja al-jami' al-shara'it, who you acted upon his opinion, who will be there with you in the court of Allah, say, yes, Ya Allah, I wrote this risala amaliyah, and this is my also opinion, based on your book and based on the saying of your prophet. Which one are you willing to take? You being in the court of Allah and defending yourself when you don't have everything to cover yourself, or letting someone to do it for you, Yawm al-Qiyamah. And that is one of the importance why we have to do that. And the last, not the least, brothers and sisters, if there is anyone who defended and protected this Islam after Allah and the Prophet and Ahlul Bayt, the next one is Ahlul Bayt. After Ahlul Bayt, Ahlul Maraja. If you want to see who protected this deen, especially Ahlul Bayt school of thought, after the Prophet and Ahlul Bayt, the next in line are the Maraja. And I don't want to go back to the history to tell you how many centuries Maraja defended and protected Islam. But I'm going to give an example where we live it today. One simple example you saw a few years ago when ISIS came to take over Iraq. When the government of Iraq couldn't even stand it. You tell me who defended Iraq that today you and I can go to Ziyarah and walk in Samarra and go to Ziyarah to this Imam and come to Kadhimin and do that Ziyarah. If not one Marja al-Jami al-Shara'it was able to do that. That Marja is nobody but Ayatollah Sayyid Sistani Hafizahullah. You know the history, how they were able to come closer to Iraq, and they were in Iraq, they were close to even Karbala. When the armies were dropping their arms, running away, until that fatwa of Samahat Ayatollah Sayyid Sistani came, by one fatwa, was able to let people to take arms and stand in front of that oppressed soldiers and cleaned Iraq from those individuals. If you don't see the power of Marja'iyah of all those years, this is one example in front of you that we live today. That's one simple example. And that is why we have to go back to a book written by one of the scholars, Muhammad Ridha Muzaffar, one of the books that every Shia should read and know the basic teaching of Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam, and it's called Aqaidul Imamiyya, the beliefs of the Shia Imamiyya, 12 who believe in 12 Imams. That's the basic teaching. And check in that book, what does he say? That's the book that they teach in the first class of a people when you enter in housing. That's the basic teaching. There is a page they call Aqidatuna fit Taqleed. What do we believe about Taqleed? There's another page called Aqidatuna fil Mujtahid. What is our proof, our belief? What is come to Mujtahid? Al-Jami' al-Shara'it. Then he goes to tell you about Mujtahid and Jami' al-Shara'it. He says, Aqidatuna fil Mujtahid al-Jami' al-Shara'it annahu na'ibul imam. That every marja who meet the conditions, he is the representative of Imam al-Hujjah. And he said, Ar-Raddu alayhi kar-Raddu ala al-Rasul wa ala al-Imam wa ala Allah. And anybody who says bad things against that Imam, that Marja, is saying or against the Imam al-Hujjah, and against Imam al-Hujjah is against the Holy Prophet, and against the Prophet is against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the power of marja'iyya, my dear brothers and sisters. Because every marja' al-jami' al-shara'it was appointed by the Imam. Now that appointing of Imam was not directly but through the hadith that we just mentioned. When that person meet those conditions, then the person is the one to follow. Now practically, every Imam have done that. One practical example, when Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, when the people of Kufa gave him letter to come, and Imam Hussein couldn't go, what did he do? He sent a representative called Muslim bin Aqil. And Muslim bin Aqil went there with a letter from Imam Hussein alayhi salam, where he said, if you are to vote for him, Muslim, you voted for me. That is Imam Hussein telling the people of Kufa, Muslim bin Aqil is my representative. If you listen to him, you listen to me. Exactly like what the Imam al-Hujjah is saying. If you follow al-marja al-jami' al-shara'i', what did you do? You automatically follow the Imam of your time. And if you refuse to follow the Imam of your time, and if you refuse to follow the mujtahid al-jami' al-shara'i', you refuse to follow the Imam of your time. And if we do not want to fall into the category of those, like those who fail to follow the teachings of the Imam. When Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam told them to follow Muslim bin Aqil, they refused to follow Muslim bin Aqil, and eventually that led them not to follow the Imam of their time, Imam al-Husayn. That on the day of Ashura, al-Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, they saw him and he told them, look left and right if you can find anyone who is the grandson of the Prophet beside me. Look at the west and look at the east. If you can find somebody who can claim he or she is the grandson of the Prophet. He said, if you don't know me and you don't believe me, he said, listen to those who know me and saw me and know my grandfather Rasulullah. And ask them, they will tell you who I am. But they didn't listen. Even they deny Imam Hussein from the access of water. Till the point where his son, Ali al-Asghar, was thirsty to the urge of dying, where the mother brought him to his father. Ya Aba Abdullah, can you get water for those children? Especially Ali al-Asghar, 6 months old. He said, Ya Aba Abdullah, look at the lips. His lips have dried. I didn't have a milk for this child for days. Can you ask the people a water for this baby? Imam Hussein took his son and he went towards the enemies. Ya ma'shar al-qawm, if I'm the criminal and you deny me the access of water, what is the crime of this child? Give him water. I said, if you don't have a deen, no religion for you, at least be free in your mind and thinking. Be human. Finally, what happened? Umar bin Sa'd la'natullahi alayhi. He looked at one of the shuras called Harmala. He said, Ya Harmala, please kill the baby to end the dispute among my army. This infant was in the arms of his father, waiting for water to be given to him. And instead, there was an arrow that came that slaughtered his jugulavin from one jugulavin to other jugulavin. Imam Zayd al-Abidin salamullahi alayhi, he said, of all the tragedy of Karbala, of all what we went through, the worst of every tragedy that we went through is killing my brother Ali al-Asghar. They ask him, what happened? He said, the moment my brother was in the hands of my father, he was waiting for water to be given. Suddenly there was an arrow. When the arrow shot him, he said, I saw my brother. فَإِذَا هُوَ يُرَفْرِفُ كَالطَّيْرِ الْمَذْبُوعِ. He said, when I looked the scene of my brother dying in the arm of my father, he said, like a bird who was shot or killed, and there's no wing to fly and didn't die from the pain. He said, that is the scene of my brother Ali al-Asghar. He said, at that moment, my father looked at him. He put his hand under the neck of my brother. He said, his hand was filled with blood. He looked at that blood. He threw it in the sky. None of that blood came down. He put the hand under the neck of his son. Again, the hand was filled with blood. But this time, he wiped on the face of his son. And he said, my son, Ali al-Asghar, I want the blood to tell Rasulullah every crime these people committed. So when you go to Allah and the Prophet, you don't have to do the talking. The blood will tell them what happened. Imam Hussein alayhi salam turned towards his wife. And the wife, who didn't know the son is already martyred, she was rushing. Hal saqayta ibni ma'a. Have you given my son water? Wajitani bi baqiyati. And brought me some of it. Imam Hussein responded with a very sad voice. أخذي ولدك مذبوحا. And take your son who has been slaughtered. من الوريد إلى الوريد. From one jugulavin to other jugulavin. إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون. والعاقبة للمتقين. Request of Surah Al-Fatiha for the ruh of Muhammad Abdullah ibn Muhammad Ishaq. May Allah be pleased with him. Surah Al-Mubarakat Al-Fatiha. Bismillah.